I'm cold. I have a cold also. And it's raining again in California all day long. Heavy here in Northern California. The rest of Southern California is, you know, just slammed. And it's like water world now. And then another big storm's coming in on Sunday. Another bigger one Monday. I mean, it's just amazing. So we're just, I'm trying to keep up with it here as far as taping goes. And today it was a tremendous day, because I did a mantra all day long. I had to. Had a terrible dream. I realized I have to raise my game up. And so I did. I said just, Apex Yoga, wow. Remedy and problem seen together. Remedy and problem seen together. If you want to know what Apex Yoga is, it means to see the remedy and the problem together. At the same moment. In the same place. No separation in time space at all. The notion of time space is a notion that somehow the problem is separated from the remedy. Right? But the remedy shows up right here, right now. There's no intermediate state at all. No intermediate state between the remedy and the problem that the remedy resolves. No intermediate state of thinking, of words, or anything like that. We experience the remedy together with the problem, just like a light, turning a light on in the darkness. The light is present in that darkness right here, right now, as the remedy for the darkness. This is called Apex Yoga. This is Apex Yoga, seeing the remedy and the problem together, simultaneous. So, I'm listening to a CD right now on low volume as I'm doing the taping. And this is a way to practice being getting used to the notion of a remedy and a problem being experienced together. Doing two things at once. There's words, and there's this gorgeous music I'm listening to at the same time. And so Apex Yoga is, again, to see the remedy flowing with everything that you're experiencing. It's right there at the same moment, in the same spaciousness, like a superimposition, okay, upon our labels and our imaginary labels and definitions. This is Apex Yoga. Very simple. Now, it's very interesting because it's so easy, actually. But what is so difficult is to fake it. And when people say, oh, it's so difficult, what they mean is, I don't think I'll be able to fake that. It's too difficult to fake. It's funny, I realized that today. It says, why does everyone say that the remedy can be seen with the problem? So it's clear that it's dispelling the problem. The problem has no power over the remedy at all. That's obvious, so simple. And so why am I all doing that? Because what we're really trying to do, almost everyone, is to fake a remedy, a fake remedy, so we can keep on with our doubt, trip. But we don't really want to do this, but our bias against certainty due to familiarity with trying to doubt reality, it keeps biasing us back into trying to fake it so we can continue with our doubt. It's this bias that we all have. We wouldn't be here if we weren't severely biased against certainty. We wouldn't be here in the world. And of course, great thanks to all the viewers and listeners here. You're doing we are together. Who knows how helpful we are? It must be very helpful, tremendously helpful, because this message is not being given out in the world. I did this YouTube. I looked up some stuff on YouTube. I had nothing to do. I said, what should I do? And I just realized, you know, how lost everyone is. They're so lost. And all the comments on the videos, they're so lost. And where is the simple truth being taught? It's not. It's being taught here. This is Apex Yoga. This is the simple truth. The remedy is seen and experienced together with the problem, so that we're aware the problem stands resolved, just as it is. It's resolved. This is the what we used to try to reflect doubt upon ourselves is now being used to reflect certainty upon ourselves, what we are, an idea in the mind of God. But we love fakery, don't we? Which casts doubt, trying to cast doubt upon reality, saying, look, I'm faking it, and that's the same as reality. So reality, maybe I kind of doubt that it's real. It might be fake too, right? That's what we've been doing for so long, fakery, that we have a very difficult time accepting just the simplicity of the remedy. And how we can be remedied from this ridiculousness that we're have been engaged with. So yeah, it's you can't fake Apex Yoga in terms of experiencing the remedy together with the problem together. Can't fake that. You cannot fake Ramana Maharshi. You can't fake that, actually. You can't fake it. So no, nobody's interested because they say, oh, it's too difficult. Too difficult to fake it. But it's easy to do it. So we're just getting past this barrier. Like, it's so easy. Why did... I always have said, it's so easy. Why don't we all do it? Yeah, this is what perplexed me coming in here. I knew it was simple and easy, but everybody's acting like, I can't find it, it's so difficult. They're ignoring it because it's too difficult to fake. They're not interested. They say, no. We want to do the easy fakery stuff, stuff that's easy to fake. So we've been attracted to that. So that's the great puzzlement kind of resolved, you know. It's so puzzling here, isn't it? Now, those that can listen to this, you have to realize you're very advanced. You're very, very advanced. Because it's very few are on this page. Very few are on this page now at this point, unfortunately. And getting to the ease and simplicity of it is the tough part here. Because people act like it's like prohibitively difficult. But again, it's prohibitively difficult to fake it. This just insight just came like about an hour ago. I just said, ah, okay, that helps. Yeah, that's the benefit of all day saying Apex Yoga, Apex Yogan, wow. Apex Yogan, wow. Remedy and problem together, seen together. Remedy and problem seen together. All day I did that. And I noticed something. If you will practice this, then I'd highly advise you do it. But I was desperate. That's why I did it. Desperation can be a great, great motivator. Every time I came across a worldly influence, suddenly the mantra changed and I was saying a different mantra. The Apex Yoga, I substituted another, a lower yoga for that in my mind. I started saying, I said, what? And it happened maybe 100 times today. Extraordinary. Odd. I catch myself, say, wait a minute. And I realized I was talking to someone, I was in a situation with people who were dualistic and saying, this is too difficult. So give us a yoga we can do, which means give us a yoga we can fake. And so I had to pull my mind back. Oh, no, it's Apex Yoga. Apex Yogan. Wow. Remedy and problem seen together. Remedy and problem seen together. Apex Yogan. Wow, Remedy and Problem Scene Together. Apex Yogan here. Remedy and Problem Scene Together. Wow. You can say it like that. Wow. Apex Yogan, wow. You can do just that. Apex Yogan, wow. So I've been doing that all day. And then suddenly this insight came that people reject it because they can't fake it. Very few are actually after liberation. Most are after trying to fake liberation so they can have their cake and eat it too, so they can still keep secretly indulging doubt. This is very true. What almost everyone in history has done this, and excluding the Dharma kings. You look at Ram Maharshi, genuine, genuine, genuine. We're so fortunate to have someone like Ram Maharshi or Sri Sri Nandamayama in our times. The genuine, Jamyang Khyentse Choki Lodro, genuine. No fakery there. Repentance is the realization that fakery will never work. It's impossible. Impossible. And then you say, oh boy, I got a lot of work ahead of me. Right? That happened to be in 1978. And at that point, I was certain that it'll never work. It can never work. Had no choice at that point. No choice. No choice. And so that's the great motivator. No choice. Certainty in realizing there's no choice. That there's only truth. Fakery will never be truth and will never satisfy us. And we get entangled with all the defenses and rationalizations of it, right? All the conflict and the fear of it. It's pathetic. It's really pathetic. And yet, everyone in the world is still doing it. It's astonishing. Forget about the world. It's all fakery. It's all the attempt at fakery. Just like to say, hey God, we're trying. We're working on it. I think we got it. And they're still holding on to doubt. Trying to serve two masters, both doubt and certainty. This is what Jesus was getting at. He said, you can't serve two masters, so be disloyal to both. But really, he's getting at, you can't serve both doubt and certainty, can you? At the same time? Together, you can serve both of those? How's that possible? Serving both doubt and certainty. You can't do it. If you try that, you'll have a mental conflict. And then all the defenses to try to deal with that. So when we get the tremendous simplicity of Apex Yoga, we'll say, well, how come no one else is doing it? You've got to get spooked. And then you realize because they're trying to find something they can fake, and you can't fake this. That's why they're not doing it. They haven't repented yet. But once they repent and realize they have no choice, then they'll start paying attention. Absolutely. They'll say, okay, get serious. If you're serious, your mind gets focused and say, wow, doubt will never work. I can never be happy with doubt. It's impossible. And then you become truly focused and desperate and start paying attention to the genuine teaching of, which is really pointing towards this great ease and simplicity. Just have the remedy appear along together with the problem. Just like light appears along together with darkness, and just turn the light on, it's right there in the midst of what was darkness, right? Same place, same time, same place. And yet, where's the darkness when the light is on? So we need to get ready for 218, Apex Yoga 218. Many will maybe at least like to just feel it a little bit, just feel it a little bit, because they're getting starting to get severe doubts about. Doubt. Starting to get some severe doubts about doubt, right? Yeah, they say this doubt trip we're on, it's not working out too well, is it? They want to see, is there some way, is there really? Yeah, there is. So this getting spooked about abidance by everyone else, you know, doing other stuff, so that's really important. Because they're looking for something that they can fake. They say, no, we can manage some really clever fakery here, and that's what we want. So don't chase after them. I mean, are they clever? I don't know. Is trying to do the impossible clever? He just ends up with mental chaos, and then you realize that doesn't satisfy either. And then you realize you have no choice. I mean, how clever is it to go down that road? It's just kind of is what it is all you can say. Yeah. I'm trying not to make my cold any worse here, so I have a hat on and a heating pad here on my knees just to cannot make excuses. I have a good old-fashioned cold, runny nose and all of that. I even got a nasal strip trying to keep my nose open. It works, actually. First time I ever tried it. I was out in the rain today a lot, got soaked. Wow. This, you know, it came down. It came down strongly most of the day. I mean, it was not just little showers. It was, I mean, the parking lots, everything, you get your shoes would get wet because there's so much standing water everywhere. So that's heavy rain. And stronger coming in a couple of days, stronger. So boy, look out for the mudslides and here at it's amazing. But you know, no complaints at all. And this is the attitude we need to have about Apex Yoga. Just take this no complaints policy, okay, into your heart. Now, We've been in such a horrendous drought in California. Scorched earth, it just breaking all our hearts to see this beautiful land on the brink of being destroyed. We lost 100 million trees. And if it had kept going, the trees were just going to die. Everything's just going to die here. And so this rain, I'm just loving it. And there's no complaints at all. I'm cheery in acceptance, and three cheers for the rain. And as far as I'm concerned, let it just keep raining as much as it wants to. If it wants to rain all year, I'm fine with that. We've had enough of the drought, okay? It was horrible. So sure, some mudslides happen, you know? Not many people are complaining, I'll tell you that. They really aren't here. They say, well, you know, we need the rain. And that's right. And we're getting on with it here and not being bothered by it too much at all. So let it rain, let the mudslides happen, and let's let it keep raining. Let it just keep raining. We'll take all the rain we can get. I don't care if it's 100 inches, as long as it's spaced out throughout the year so it doesn't get, the flooding doesn't get bad. Because we have to replenish the underground water table, which was like in a devastatingly low condition. That has to be replenished. So we just need it to rain and rain and rain and rain and rain, and we'll put up with the inconveniences. We will, absolutely we will. It's the same thing with Apex Sugar. We've been like wandering in a spiritual desert, in a spiritual drought for so long. We're in a horrible spiritual drought in the world right now. Just horrible. So we have Apex Yoga come along. It's just like, wow, bring it on, It's all good. It's all good. Just put complaints out of your heart and just say, we're not going to complain. We're not going to nitpick. We're just not going to do it. It is really like that, like this. And I have to remember that. I'm so grateful for where we're at right now. It's just tremendous. So at Apex Yogan doesn't entertain complaints at all. They just don't entertain complaints. They say, wow, this is great. Just like we're not complaining about the rain in California. We're just smiling and say, isn't this great? Isn't this great? I'm soaked today. I just, that's okay, man. That's fine. Not a problem. Not a problem. And we understand. It's a great experience, learning experience to go through this. Because we know what this is helping us free us from is that horrible drought. And so we understand that it's liberating us from that drought. So we don't complain about what's liberating us, right? Apex Yoga is literally liberating us from this devastating spiritual drought in the world. I believe the worst in history. The voices of spiritual drought are have been drowning out wisdom here in this world for so long. So a drought buster is what we need. We really need drought, but drought busters and these storms coming in into California, it's just like one after the other after the other, and they just don't stop. They've been just going now for, oh wow, month and a half or so, I mean, or maybe more. But every 4 days or so, right? And it's like one, two, three. They come in threes. So like three big storms, one after the other. Then they're gonna break for 4 days, and three more storms, and a break, and three more. And it's just like, wow. Wow. So I'm gonna try not to say, enough's enough. That's enough. We don't want any more. I'm gonna try not to say that. I said, no. You just keep bringing the storms in as long as you want. We want the drought to just be an ancient memory that we forget all about. Just like we want the spiritual drought in this world to be something that just evaporates and we forget all about it. And it's like that. I know I'll forget this time, this period in the world, as if it never happened. It was just a bad memory that's gone. It's not a keeper. It's not a keeper at all, right? So it's like a terrible drought. It seems kind of interesting until there's no water, and then it's not so interesting anymore. and everything around you is dying for lack of water. And they just say, this isn't good. This is not interesting. I'm not interested in this anymore. And so the spiritual drought in the world has been so terrible. And all the gadgets that, you know, we've gotten, our attention has been momentarily distracted by them all. You know, it's not so interesting anymore, is it? They're not so interesting anymore. And we'll forget all about them. We'll forget all about it. When people are in a drought state, spiritual drought state, they get very pathetic in their inability to you know, direct their attention in the right direction. Feeble, they become very feeble. They seem spiritually feeble. This is what the way the world is right now, very spiritually feeble. It's just extraordinary. I believe my friend who's has this terrible cancer, feels like he's going to die soon. I feel like he doesn't want to be here anymore. But an apex yogin is called to tough it out. And we have to keep faith that you know, we need to be drought busters. We need to be part of busting the drought. Someone has to, right? I mean, and we're called to do so. Apex yogins are called, they're drought busters. The play of attention that's going on in the world right now is just so feeble, it's shockingly feeble because of the influences that have been at play recently in the world. It's really enfeebled us, our attention. And again, very few actually have even gotten to the truth at all, in terms of, oh, okay, so this is true. Again, they're still trying to find some way to fake the truth, fake the remedy, a fake remedy. Still, after that, wow. I used to think that the Christians had feeble spiritual knowledge, but compared to the way things are now, they were strong in comparison, really. I mean, we're way more feeble now. They actually, you know, had some strengths. Some. I heard some astonishing things from my Christian friend. That sounds very much like A Course in Miracles, although he's an Old Testament, New Testament Christian type. Well, he was telling me, I didn't say anything, but I said, my gosh, that's what Jesus is saying in A Course in Miracles. You can't find freedom in lies. There is none. But he got that from the Bible and traditional Christianity. So that there has been some strength in Christianity, and you see it now by how feeble the world has become. You realize, oh my gosh, there was something built up there. There really was. But in succumbing to these times, to a large extent, there was still this lack of understanding about familiarity is what tripped everyone up. As soon as you understand that familiarity is our problem, you don't get confused anymore. You don't. You just realize you got to get to work. There's no confusion. I got to get to work. Like, I don't wake up confused. I wake up saying, gosh, I got to get to work. More work I have to do here. The only confusion is, it's not confusion, it's just complaint. I say, haven't I done enough? You know? I did this great video yesterday, and I thought, I'm going to have a tremendous sleep, and I woke up early in the morning with, like, the worst nightmare of my life. I was like, what? That's crazy. So, and you realize, wow, today's another day I'm going to do, like, more work than any ever. And so, but people are so feeble now. They're all into this entitlement thing. Like, my phone will do the work for me. So, they don't do the work. They're afraid to do the work. But you know, traditional Christianity, you're supposed to work all your whole life really hard on your faith. So, you know, in hindsight, looking at it, say, wow. To throw that away, that momentum away, and it's all over the issue of familiarity. That's it. Nobody got that. Nobody really got it. Didn't see it. It's the snake. It's the hidden. It's the hidden elephant in the room that we just don't know what it is. So finally seeing it, that it's just familiarity, and that creates this bias against certainty that has no reason to it, no rhyme or reason to it at all. It's just flat out bias. We're biased. We want to go back to what we're used to, even though we know it's like St. Paul said that. He said, even though I know what I'm doing is wrong, I keep doing it. That's called familiarity. Bias towards familiarity. What you're familiar with, you go back to that, even though you know it's wrong. Be it ever so humble, there's no place like home. No place like familiarity. That's our entire problem, really. That's what keeps stalling us out, tripping us up. And when we stall out and get tripped up, then we start saying, wow, it's so difficult. I don't know what's going on. Maybe God doesn't want me to succeed. So maybe God wants me to doubt. And then you end up for faking, you know, some sort of fakery, fake remedy. So in no way does God want us to fail, to realize nature of reality is totally certain. In no way does God want us to fail. No way does God throw obstacles in our path. It's familiarity that throws the obstacles, the familiarity bias throws obstacles in our path. Nothing else, nothing else, nothing else. So get this one recognition for yourself, and from then on you're unstoppable, because you'll work at it. You're unstoppable because you're willing to work at it, because you now know what the problem really is. If you don't know what the problem is, you'll get discouraged. You say, I'm not sure. Maybe am I working on the problem? Maybe I'm not. And then you get discouraged and you quit. But if you know what the problem is, then you can just directly work on it. And you realize I'm getting there. And even though it's difficult and it takes a long time, still, next day you work at it again, as I've done every day without, I don't skip days, I don't miss days, I don't take a day off, because why? I know I'm working on the problem, and I know today if I put in a good day's work, it's that much closer to being free of the problem. So there's no reason to not do it. My sin is familiarity with doubt. That's it. That's the only sin we have, is just familiarity with doubt, which biases us against certainty. Unreasonably so, yes, but it's still there. We can't just reason it away. What we can do is get used to reason and get familiar with it. But as far as just zapping it with reason and expecting it to go away, that won't happen. Because familiarity is not something you just argue away. Like, okay, I debate. You can't debate it away. Okay, you cannot debate it away. So debate is useless. It's useless. Cannot debate it away. Argumentation is useless. Just skillful practice in continuously, like I say, apex yoga. Wow, apex yoga, wow. Apex yoga, wow. Meaning I'm an apex yogin, wow. I'm doing apex yoga, wow. Apex yoga, wow. It just brings this kind of smelling salts to us. And just doing that like all day, that's what really helps you advance. Not getting in arguments with, it does nothing. Trips us up. So when your mind goes into arguing, you may be arguing with some mental people in your mind, thinking that they're going to ask me questions and I need to explain to them and they get in an argument. Don't do that. Don't do it. Just go right back to apex yoga. Wow. Remedy and problem together, seen together. Apex yoga, wow. Remedy and problem seen together. So since the remedy is always greater than the problem, the help is greater than the problem with the grace of God, there's no reason to argue about the problem. Just put your attention on the remedy and get used to the remedy. We've been used to the problem for so long. Now we just have to get used to the remedy, okay? Which is seeing the remedy and the problem together, so we can recognize that it truly is the remedy for the problem, right? We experience it. So we turn our attention away from the problems onto the remedy and get familiar with that. And once we're familiar enough with the remedy, then the bias will be gone and then we'll accept it. We can get glimpses of it, but then the bias gets in. Familiarity bias creeps in and we say, we go back to, you know, doubt again and arguing and struggling with doubt, trying to cure doubt by trying to say, doubt you're wrong, or say, that doesn't work. We just don't worry about doubt. We know it's wrong, but what we want to say is the apex yoga, wow, full stop in the wow. In other words, I know the answer, wow. I know the remedy, wow. Remedy and problem seen together, wow. I'm an apex yogin, wow. Apex yoga is you could say it's the, I don't want to say highest because that gives legitimacy to fakery or something. It's apex yoga is what works. Okay. It's not a graduated progressive path. It's direct awareness, bare direct awareness of what the remedy really is, which is to see the remedy together with the problem. Okay? It's not directly together. Okay? Right now together. Right here, right now together. The remedy and the remedy with the problem. And so we experience this. We don't think about it. We experience it. So apex yoga is about experiencing remedy and problem together. And then we realize, the remedy really is a remedy for the problem that we have had. And we get more and more used to this remedy, get more familiar with it. Where we used to try to cast doubt upon what we are, now we're casting certainty upon what we are. So it's still a reflection, right? But now it's what we're reflecting. So the mirror is still there. And all the things we're used to seeing in the mirror, the world is still there, except now it's casting certainty upon what we are. So if we're going to dispel darkness, do we take the light somewhere else other than the darkness, or do we turn it on in the darkness? We turn the light on in the darkness. So we bring the remedy and the problem together and let the remedy shine where the problem has been. Don't try to separate them mentally. No mental separation. That's the trouble that we all have. Separation in time, separation in space, using thoughts, concepts to try and separate. But again, this is quite easy to do, but it's impossible to fake. Most, all of us want to be, are trying to be the greatest fakers of all time. That's true. And so we think, no, if I'm the greatest faker of all time, you know, I win a prize. Well, yeah, prize of mental chaos. And you say, well, that's not such a great prize. I'm not really interested in that anymore. And I say, oops. So I'm really working for this to experience remedy and problem together, so that it can remedy can be recognized and experienced. So I have something to do. I'm God's blocking everything for me. Everything keeps being blocked, and I say, God, I don't have anything to do. Doesn't want me to do this, then not this, not this, not this, not this. And I said, yeah, you're right. Legitimately, you're right. But, you know, what can I do? I kind of just like sit in a chair and just kind of say, what should I do? But I just try to stay patient and keep trying to practice mentally apex yoga. Wow. Just that. Apex yoga. Wow. I'm bored. Apex yoga. Wow. I need to take a rest. Apex yoga. Wow. And just be aware when you change them, the mantra gets changed through worldly influences. You try to please them, you'll go back into some sort of, you know, fakery yoga. Amazing. Oh, some situations didn't cause it. Like looking at pictures of Ramaharshi, it didn't cause me to lose track of apex yoga mantra at all. Whereas talking with worldly people, I started saying the wrong mantra. I said, what am I doing? Amazing. So when you discover this, try it, and you discover this is a very, very revelatory type of experience. You say, oh my gosh, the world is really dragged down into dualism, isn't it? I've been working all day long on some old forgotten graves. I can't sing. The cold has knocked me out. Oh, man, Papa, rest. Nope. It's funny. Just when I was starting to sing great again, I get another cold. So God's blocking that. It's amazing. The first cold I got this winter, I was just singing. I was just like a bird. It was just fabulous. Best I've ever sung in my life. Got a cold and it knocked it out. And then I just got it back again after a couple months. I was just coming back again, and this another cold came, and it's gone again. Huh. God's blocking that. But the one thing he's not blocking is apex yoga. Apex yoga, if someone asks you what's apex yoga, you say apex yoga, wow. It's so cool that we can't even explain it. It's so great we can't even explain it. We just wow it. the top yoga, no words should be used to explain it. Really, it, wow. We just wow it. Wow. Because we know it works. We know it's super simple. Super easy, super simple. And, you know, it, wow. Apex yoga, how do you explain it? Wow. What's it about? Wow. And those who want to wonder, try to, they ask questions because they're trying to, they're thinking like, is there some way to fake this? And we say just, wow. They say, huh, that doesn't help me. But those who can accept the wow, just wow, then that's a great sign, you know, it's a great indicator. You're comfortable. You don't, you're not trying to fake your liberation, fake liberation. So wow is enough. It's good enough. Wow. Apex yoga, wow. We are in touch with apex yoga, and that is just wow, wowish, plain and simple. When you're in the same groove as Ramaharshi, you really get it, and you recognize, yeah. Wow, really? Just say wow, right? I mean, do you need to explain it, or is that how you feel? You feel like explaining it now? You feel like just saying wow? I don't feel like explaining it too much. I mean, or at least very simple explanation of why it's just wow. And looking at all these YouTube videos of very spiritual teachers, I don't want them to explain anything. You don't need to, just the presence, please. The presence isn't there. Come on, just give me the presence. I don't need to hear anything. I don't need to hear you say anything. And that's what we're aiming towards in 218. That we accept that. It's just, yeah, apex yoga is just wow. A few words here and there. Okay, fine. But it's just wow. It's just wow. What really works is wow, right? Wow, this really works. Amazing. After everything we've tried hasn't worked. Because we're trying to fake it. Finally, we stop trying to fake it, and lo and behold, we have what works. Wow. We don't know how much longer this rain will happen, keep coming. I mean, after this next series of three more storms, three more pulses of atmospheric river content, then it should looks like about, you know, maybe we get a break for a week or so, or, you know, it's actually some sunny days, sunny and cloudy days. So, but we don't know if something else then is going to come rolling in again. Yeah, it might, right? Let it come, let it come. It, you know, it's kind of difficult to forecast like 15 days ahead of time, 10, 15 days ahead of time. It, you don't know what's going to be stirred up in the Pacific, and how exactly, you know, it's going to come in, what the jet stream is going to be like. So I don't get anything out of the internet and other teachers in the world, and I just don't get anything out of it anymore. Apex Yoga, wow. I feel like fundamentally different now. I just can't generate any interest in it anymore. All the other stuff, just not interested in it. It's like, and I look at it and say, like, was I interested in that at some point? Really? Couldn't have been genuine interest. Could not have been. The interest had to be in faking it, right? Faking truth so doubt can be kept going. But really, all this nonsense in the world, we're not really interested in it. Not genuine interest. We're not. I was never genuinely interested in this world. And really, no one is. We're just interested in trying to cast doubt upon ourselves and trying to automate it, and interested to see if we can actually do it and cause that God to doubt, cause doubt in within God. We're trying to see if we can do that, and the answer is we can't do it. But we're so interested in it, we keep trying, even though I say you can't do it. I know we can't. Most just keep on trying anyway. Man, some of the good ones are leaving this world. My friend, he said he's resigned now to make he's focused on making a smooth transition out of this world, just like that. And I say, you know, we could use your presence here for a little bit longer. Seriously, you know, you don't know what 218 will bring. Maybe it'll bring Apex Yoga. It's likely, actually, it'll bring Apex Yoga. You know, we could really use you there. Be a drought buster. I feel like bringing my friend a gemstone. He's really into gems. Maybe I'll ask Baba Samava to give me something and I'll bring it to him. Maybe that will like restore his interest and staying around a little while. All right? I don't care about gems. If he gave me a big diamond, I just give it to him. I'm not interested in gems. Doesn't mean anything to me. I'd give him a chest full of gems. I'd give him a mountain full of gems if he wanted to. I don't want gems. I have Apex Yoga. That's the gem that I've been looking for. I'd give him an ocean of gems. Imagine an ocean, just a gemmy ocean. The whole ocean is just this gorgeous, gemmy ocean. Yeah, it's a nice, be a nice experience. But boy, does he love gems. He was a jeweler and a gemologist, and he wears a lot of gems. He's so knowledgeable about them and loves them. So, yeah. Let's ask the Dharma Kings to give our friend some gems that can heal his mind, can turn his attention in a direction that, you know, better direction. Is there anything of this world that has value? Not really, no. Is there something that I could get acquired that I like? I'm saying like, ah, this has value. I want to keep this. Not much. Maybe the golf driver. I said, well, I need this to play golf, because of pragmatic reason. So I could say that, but other than that, I can't really think of anything. And probably after I hit a couple dry wayward drives, I might say, ah, I don't want this club either. I haven't hit anything with it yet, so it's had no bad memories associated with it. So yeah. So right now I'm 100. I'm batting 100, 100%, right? Batting 1,000. Haven't hit any bad drives with it. Haven't hit any good ones either, but there's no bad ones. That's like, ah, it's nice. Maybe I'll just keep it that way. Never hit a bad drive with this driver. Just never use it. I mean, what is it that we have to have? I mean, actually, other than just, basic needs to, but what is it that something we actually have to have something? What? Well, I guess you'd have to say some nice music occasionally is like what I'm listening to right now is as pleasant. But all the stuff that in stores, I don't need any of it. I'm not really interested in any of it. Anything that you can buy, I'm not interested in that. All these fancy homes and stuff, I'm not interested in it. So the world holds very little interest for me. Even if someone gave me a pile of gold, I'd just say, "Here, you want it? It's just to me, it's just dirt. Take it. I don't want it." Yellow dirt, there's no value in that. Apex yoga, wow, that's what has value. Just a simple insight that remedy and problem seen together. Just that. Wow, that's all you need to know. We've been trying to keep the two apart, and that's why we don't recognize the remedy for what it really is. So, and how it really resolves it for us, everything for us. Keeping it apart in time, it doesn't seem to be a remedy. Keeping it apart in space, it doesn't seem to be a remedy. It seems to be faulty. But if you see it, same time, space, together, see it together, simultaneously. Then you recognize, oh, it is a remedy. So that the remedy's always been with us. We've just been thinking it's not a remedy because we try to interject time, different space. Like, oh, it's not here right now. The problem I have right now, it comes later. So that's not quite, doesn't quite work for what, you know. As soon as we create this time difference, our space difference, doesn't seem to be an effective remedy. But allow it to be right here, right now, with the problem, with no separation time space, and then it seems, then we'll see, it's the perfect remedy. Apex yoga, wow. Right? Apex yoga, wow. It's getting a little chilly out here. I'm not really suffering that bad from the cold. My throat's not sore or anything, but it's just, I feel tired, really tired. Just feel blah. You know, got the blahs. But even when we have the blahs, we can still focus and apex yoga, wow, right? Yeah, all day long I was doing that, right? In the midst of a cold, the momentum continues. I mean, most of the my life on the spiritual path, I've been very ill. Felt terrible blahs, a lot of it horrible. But I said, well, I can at least, you know, read some apex yoga, put my attention on something and consider it, even though I feel terrible. So don't make any excuses. Do what you can. You keep your attention, play of attention towards truth, even though you have the blahs. If we waited till we felt great before we even pay attention, we never pay attention, hardly more than a few days. I mean, how many days in my life have I felt great? I really don't know if there's been a single one, actually. I really don't know if I've ever felt good or great in my life at all. I know, like, when I wake up in the morning, how many times have I felt good when I wake up in the morning? I think maybe a few times in my life, maybe. And that's it. Usually when I wake up, I feel terrible. I remember once I woke up and I felt great. I said, well, something's wrong. What's wrong? I don't know how it happened. I really don't. I'd like to know, you know, what the, how that took place. But, no, I feel lousy all the time. Just not making excuses. You can't make excuses. Because I can always say apex yoga, wow. Apex yoga, wow. I'm an apex yogin, wow. Apex yoga is wow. So fortunate, wow. So blessed, wow. Because when we look at the others in this world struggling so badly, we realize how blessed we are. But I try not to look at it too much because you get survivor guilt, kind of like, wow, I mean, is it right for me to be blessed and everyone else? Well, they're rejecting the blessing. It's there for them. The remedy's there for them just the same as it is for me. They just refuse it because they're looking for a fake remedy. so they can continue to believe they can be greater than God. So it's just their arrogance, you know, and that's rejecting it. And continuity fear is keeping that intact. The whole dance, the dance of continuity fear is, you know, because of the bias, familiarity bias against certainty keeps it going. Continuity fear, say, I'm scared of that, even though it's good for me, I'm scared of it. It's like, hey, you want to try something new? There's a new food. Sometimes older people say, no, I don't want to try that. I don't want to try that. Because they're not used to it. They just say, I don't know what it is. I don't know what it'll be. I want to try something that I'm used to. I want to stick with what I'm familiar with. Now, when we're young, we might like try like all sorts of different stuff. And so we think that we're really, oh, I'm not hung up on familiarity problem. Not true. Because what you find out is when you're young, you'll try all sorts of different stuff, but you won't really settle on anything that works. And that's still familiarity bias. It's natural for young people to say, huh, I've never tried that. Let me try that. Let me try this. Let me try that. And when you're older, you say, I've already tried all that stuff. I'm not really that interested in it anymore. Yeah. So the sooner you can really focus on apex yoga, the better. I know that I would say, well, that other stuff's interesting, but let me keep working on what I know is going to work. And if I can spend a little time and look at the other stuff, fine. But let me make sure I take care of business first here and keep focused on what really works. In the world of the doubters, they always highlight those who are not, you know, apex yogins. They always highlight them and do videos and movies and books and everything. Generally speaking, that's how it goes, because they want to believe that faking a remedy is the answer, because that's what they're after. So if they see someone who's really clever at faking a remedy, they're gonna say, "Wow, this is it for me. You know, that's great." So you'll be champion them, you know, say, ah, there's our champion. But if you present what really works and can't be faked, they're not interested. So they're not going to talk you up at all. You're not their champion. Apex yoga, wow. So apex yogins, wow, the fact that they're apex yogins. Okay? That's the primary mantra, you might say. Wow, I'm an apex yogin, wow. Wow. That's the primary practice, you might say. Yeah, it is. Pretty simple, isn't it? So as you discover this, is it during the day you just say, apex yogin, wow, apex yogin, wow. Use it all the time. Going to the grocery store, I was doing it. Wherever I went, I was just apex yogin, wow. So you don't need to search around like, oh gee, I don't know. Just say Apex Yogan Wow. I'm an Apex Yogan Wow. Wow. I made it, you know? Wow. I've got it. Wow. It's big time. Apex Yogan is big time. The sensationalistic stuff in the world, tabloid stuff, is that's not it, of course. They champion these various yogis and say this is that's those aren't true yogis. I mean, that's silly stuff. Come on. But just because they popularize all that stuff doesn't mean there aren't real genuine yogins, right? There are, they're just not being championed. Not being popularized. Dion, for instance, the great singer Dion DiMucci, when he was doing pop stuff, he was popularized and big time. Then he went Christian. He went Christian and started doing Christian music. Stopped doing the other stuff. He really changed his life, and we didn't hear him again. Didn't hear of him. Like he disappeared. I heard a religious song, Christian song Dion did recently. It was just fabulous. I mean, are you kidding me? He's one of the best singers in history. And I just listened to him sing. I said, "Oh my God, yeah!" I never even heard of this. It doesn't get popularized unless you're really in the know. You're not gonna even know about it. I need to listen to some more of Dion's Christian music. It's just, what a brilliant singer. With a just a great soulful style. But for most of the world, if it's not mainstream, if the mainstream doubter culture, doubt culture, isn't popularizing it, doesn't exist to them. They don't even know about it. People don't pay attention to Nanda Mai Ma, Sri Sri Nanda Mai Ma, because they can't fake it. They can't fake her, you know? So they say, ah, oh, it's too difficult to fake. Yeah, that's to say the least. Take one look at it, you say, I can't fake that. No way. No way. Some have tried. Some, yeah. But it's so obvious, instantly obvious. It's just, okay. Silly. But we could say Apex Yoga, wow, right? Instead of trying to fake something, just say Apex Yoga, wow. So the world is just this dance of bias right now against certainty. That's all it is. Just a dance of bias. It doesn't, we don't need to draw any distinctions between bias. Bias is bias. It's doubt. We don't need to draw any distinctions between various in doubt within doubt, do we? The only distinction we need to make is that reality is certain, so doubt is meaningless. So all doubt is equally meaningless. All doubt is equally meaningless. The world has gone Babylon. It really has, hasn't it? It really has. Apex Yoga, wow. Okay, so it's 11 o'clock, and I don't want to... I'm going to take care of my health a little bit here. Apex Yoga, wow. Just that practice, just that. That's a central practice. Apex Yoga, wow. Do just that. I'm going to try. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. I tried that today, and it's an eye-opener. Apex Yoga, wow. Apex Yoga, wow. Okay. All right, very great. Apex Yoga, wow. And just keep fertilizing the tree that way. And the fruits will come. The fruits will come. We keep fertilizing, watering, fertilizing, getting the tree light. And the fruits are going to come. They will come. Yes, they will. So Apex Yoga, wow, wow, wow. And that's it.